A very good morning, my dear class 4 children. Welcome back once again. So today let us start another new lesson of English 1, that is an imaginative paragraph writing. It is in page 42 of your English 1 book. An imaginative paragraph can be a story, an autobiography, picture stories, guided compositions, or about incidents. So, when you write an imaginative paragraph, you have to use your imagination to the fullest. Like when you were in class 3, some of you have shared or some of you have made your own stories, written your own stories and shared them with me, right? So, they were all examples of imaginative stories. They were about your own imagination. So, I hope you have read or watched the movie Jungle Book. Right? It is also an example of one's imagination. Everything can happen in an imagination. Like in Jungle Book, we can see the animals talking. Do you think that animals talk, or have you seen animals talking? No, animals do not talk. But everything can happen in one's imagination. We can imagine of the fairies, we can imagine of vampires, we can imagine of aliens too. So, you have to use your imagination when you write an imaginative paragraph writing. So it is very much important for us to learn, as it will develop our creative writing skills. So today in this lesson, I'll be giving you some points that need to be kept in mind in order to write a creative or imaginative paragraph writing. There are some points in your book too. Please refer them. They are very important. First thing that you have to keep in mind is that think about the topic and note down all that comes to your mind. You have to think of the appropriate topic. Okay? After thinking, you will get number of ideas. Note down all those ideas and select the appropriate idea that matches with your paragraph or that matches with your story. Okay, and next thing that you have to keep in mind is that of the characters. Remember, the characters can be people, animals, or creatures. It is not necessary that the characters must be the human beings. It can be animals also, talking animals, or about talking birds, or you can choose the creatures too as your character. Like you can select the aliens, or you can write about the vampires, ghosts, witches. So choose, select appropriate character that matches with your idea or with your paragraph. Next comes settings. It includes where and when your story took place. It is a time or place of a paragraph. Like your paragraph, you can write about the setting, like the paragraph can be taken at night in a haunted house, or during or at a beach, or it can take place in an unknown planet, or in a city, or at your own home. So you decide what will be the perfect setting for your paragraph that will match your idea or match the theme of your paragraph. Next, after selecting the characters and the settings, you can start writing your paragraph. But please make sure that your paragraphs must have three things, that is beginning, middle, and an end. They are very important. At the beginning, you can introduce the characters and the settings. And in the middle, you can write interesting events that take place, or you can write the challenges or the problems faced by the characters, or you can write the solutions, or you can write the turning point of the paragraph will be in the middle, or the main part will be in the middle of the paragraph. And closing, you have to conclude the paragraph in a logical way. You have to use your creativity when you end your paragraph. A paragraph can be ended in a funny note, or it can be ended where the characters have learned the lesson or the readers have learned the lesson. So it is up to you how will you end the paragraph. But do not forget that you have to end the paragraph logically. So, children, in an imaginative paragraph writing, you have to keep these things in mind. You have to choose appropriate characters and then settings, and then it must have beginning, middle, and then end. So these are few things, basic thing that need to be kept in mind while writing an imaginative paragraph. But the most important thing is that you have to use your own imagination when you write your own paragraph, imaginative paragraph, and your imagination should not match with your friend's imagination, because we do not imagine same, right? So think and imagine. I hope you have understood whatever I had explained you. Please, along with watching the video, I want you to go through the points which is in your book, which is in page 42, and read the sample of imaginative paragraph writing, and then you will learn more about imaginative paragraph. And after that, your homework is to do any one paragraph, okay, which is in page 43. You can select any one from there. There is an escape, then when I became the detective, a terrifying experience. From there, you can select any one which will be easier for you. There are some hints, refer to that also, that will help you. Then do any one and submit me. Thank you very much and have a good day.